You're one of the best coaches in the history of boxing. The only coach that has two fighters right now with multiple belts in their division. Congratulations on Spence win, and now a chance to have all the belts at 154. What do you think, Gary?
I'm happy to be here, man. I'm ready, ready to get this thing going. Ready for Charlo to be the first. So it's all about being the first with four belts in a 154-pound division.
So obviously, to me, he's one of the best pound-for-pound fighters. Jermell, yeah. And after he wins, obviously he'll be cemented. Yeah. How do you feel when you see like different people making their list and they skip his name, and he should be there?
You know, it's all subjective. I mean, I think everybody had their own personal choice, who they like and what they think, you know, and maybe to them, or they don't see what they feel like they need to see, but they put other people on. It's okay. It's all subjective. What we like as individuals.
What did you think of the Canelo fight? Did you happen to watch it?
No, I didn't see it. Heard about it, but I didn't see it.
He's getting a lot of backlash. I mean, winning is part of boxing, not winning is part of boxing, but you're still a great fighter. You don't have to win every fight.
I think that, well, you set out to win every fight, but I think that it just depends on how it goes. I think that you can play a card for so long and it can get you so far, but, you know, these guys are too big, too strong. He was faster, I'm sure he was faster than Bivol, but somebody asked me, what do I think about the fight? I said, before the fight, I said that if Bivol has good timing, and a good jab, it'll be very difficult. Because a great little guy can always beat a good big guy or a decent big guy. But it's different when you fight another great big guy who's bigger than you and he has the same, you know, skill set. So, I mean, different.
Well, I have a tough question. A lot of people feel that Errol Spence is the best 147-pounder on the planet. He has three belts. He's beat everybody.
Right.
But then a lot of people are different. I shouldn't say a lot. News outlets puts Crawford right now as pound-for-pound king. How can you be pound-for-pound king if you're not even the number one guy in your division?
I think that they just contradict. It's always contradictory because I've seen somebody say that Errol was the top 147-pounder, but how can somebody else be on the top of the list? I mean, it's all subjective. Like, just like the other question you asked me earlier, I think that people love Crawford and people love Errol Spence. So, I mean, I think that that's what it is. Facts are facts.
I know you're the coach, but do you think the fight happens soon? Spence and Crawford?
Well, you know, I mean, I want what my guy wants. And I think we want this fight. We've been working on it. So, you know, before the fight, we'll see if he takes it. That's all it's all about. I mean, but, you know, not here, you know, Spence, he is the James Crawford. We'll see.
And last thing, so what can fans expect this weekend? Jermell Charlo Castaño rematch?
Yeah, we're going to expect Jermell Charlo to be the new undisputed, you know, light middleweight champ of the world.
He's focused, he's happy, he looks on weight right now.
He's good, man. He's zoned in. Ready to go, man. We're going to see a good, great fight.
Make sure everybody, Derrick D. James on Instagram. Make sure to follow
Derrick D. James 1.
Derrick D. James 1 on Instagram. Stay tuned, and big things coming this year. And hopefully, you know, and things go well. Trainer of the year.
Hey, man, I'm not living my life by, you know, winning no type of awards, because obviously it'll always be, they always find somebody. Remember, I was told them before, they always dig somebody up. When they told me that Teofimo's father did something better than what I did with two fighters and me, with one fighter, they always going to dig somebody up.
Yeah, but it's not fair, but we know, all right?
Fair, you know, man, fair is a made-up word.
Derrick James in the house. At least like back reporting.